People who dress like that, when they walk into clubs, when they walk into bars, when they walk into establishments, when they walk into any kind of upscale joint, people become uncomfortable. You see, and people always say you shouldn't judge someone by the way they look. I say yes. I say you need to judge someone by the way they look. Because human instincts, human intuition, this is how we are by as human beings by default. We need to make a quick assessment of someone before we approach them or before we interact with them on any kind of level. And this is how you assess people. This is how you judge people. By the way they walk, by the way they talk, by their posture, by the way they carry about themselves, by their gestures, just their whole overall appearance and whole overall interaction they have with people and society. And I am saying that people who walk around with durag, twisted cap, baggy jeans, baggy clothes generally, oversized clothes and these big old Timberlands, I am saying that this class of people, obviously they're not upscale or middle class. They fit into a lower class of society. They fit into a lower spectrum. And one of the reasons I am saying this is because they walk into a certain establishment and people become paranoid because it's a stereotype. It sends a bad message. It's a bad stigma of who they are. It doesn't matter if you're educated. It doesn't matter if you're rich and famous. I am saying, let's be realistic, people. This culture and mentality, it appeals to a lower class. I am not saying that if you choose to wear a baggy jeans or durag and dress in all that little nasty hip-hop culture gear, I am not saying that you are a bad person. I am saying that it is associated with a lower class. This is a mentality, and this is a culture, and this is a style of dressing that appeals to people of the lower spectrum of life. You cannot debate with me, you cannot argue with me, because it's pointless. I am proving a point. It is a fact.
The epitome of society, guys like 50 Cent and Puff Daddy and all these guys. These are the scums of the media that promote a negative, bad, low-class, inferior, mediocre, artificial stereotype that goes with this whole style of dressing. It promotes mediocrity. And I am saying that scums like Puff Daddy and all, and these rappers like 50 Cent, I think they should face the firing squad. I think the United States government should assassinate them. I think that these people should be assassinated. You should get up one morning and hear that they were assassinated. You cannot sit there and debate with me and define to me that dressing in a baggy clothes is classy, or wearing a durag or a big old nasty Timberland boots. No, your only debate is the fact that it's a so-called hip-hop trend. It's a trend. It's a style. Oh, it's 2006 and it's a style and that's what happened. I say no. I say the people who carry about themselves like that, they generally speak a certain way. They speak in Ebonics, like, yo, my nigga, son, you gonna be hollering my crib later, son? Hell yeah, so, yo, see that bitch ass? Yo, she got a fine ass, nigga. She got a fine ass, for real, son. Yo, that bitch ass, I'm gonna be hollering back at my crib later, dog, for real, holla back. That's how they talk, man. That's how these low-life scums, that's how they talk. They're scum. They're garbage. They're filled in society. They're low-life. And, this is the problem we have. These are the people that walk into establishments and people become paranoid and they leave the establishment crying racism. It's not racism, it's the way you carry about yourself. Now this spreads across the border because not only these so-called African Americans dress like this, you have Indians, white Chinese, you have many different races that dress like this. So I'm not talking about the race, I'm talking about the class. What I'm defining here to you is classism. I'm dealing with class. You understand me? Different class. And I say it's low life. It is low life. It is scum.
I don't associate myself with that mentality. I don't associate myself with that class of people, that particular class of people. I don't. I don't interact with it because that's not my culture. That is rubbish. That's not who I am. So if you listen to this video right now, if you're looking at me and you wear durag, you wear baggy clothes, you wear old, big old nasty Timberland boots, if that's the way you dress, I want you to know, you are a low life.
You are a low life. You are low class. You are from the lower spectrum of society. You are filth. You are garbage. Because I am saying this to you. No classy person, no human being in their right mind, in any form of sanity, would walk the streets in baggy clothes with a big old boots and a durag and a twisted cap. That is low class. And that defines who you are. And people say never judge a book by its cover. Yes, you need to judge a person by the way they look. And if that's the way you look, then I will call the police because I think you are coming to rob me. You are a lowlife. Did you hear what that?
That's why I will always love Wayne Brady and Bill Cosby. You hear what Bill Cosby said?
You!
Anyway, what else is there to say? Nothing. If you like what I just said, leave a comment. If you don't like it, listen. If you don't like my... Listen, I am not... Have a blessed day. Mm-hmm. By the way, Jesus died on the cross. Repent.